Hi all, in today's video I'm going to show few tips and tricks in SAP GUI. Tip number 1, to enter date in SAP GUI. To enter date, just type it like 01/01/2021 and 20/06/2021. Just press enter. So system automatically converts it to date format. Tip number 2, to skip initial screen. Here I am using the T code MMBE. Okay, I just execute it. Okay, I will just come back from this screen. So now I want to see the same material stack again. To see the same material stack again, just enter /*MMBE. So it skips the initial screen, it directly opens the result screen. So I will take one more example, okay, /NME23N, okay. So from this screen, I want to see the stock of this material. I want to close this screen, I want to see the stock of this material, okay. Just enter /N*MMBE. It closes the present screen and directly opens the main screen. I mean result screen. See, it is, skips the initial screen, showing the directly result. Tip number 3, how to see the authorization object. So for example, here I'm running the T code SU01. I don't have the authorization of this T code. To see the authorization object, just click on the system. Here, go to utilities, click on display authorization check. So in this way, we can see the authorization object, or we can use the T code SU53. Tip number 4, to select the field value. To select the field value, this field length is too lengthy, so it is difficult to drag, okay. So instead of that, we can do like this. Just press and hold the control key. Just click on this number, it automatically selects. Okay, now we can copy this value and we can paste it wherever we want. And also we can do like this. Just click on the customization local layout. Activate this quick cut and paste. Yeah, now press and hold the control key. Just click on this number, it automatically selects and automatically copies also. Now we can paste the copied value wherever we want. For example, I'm pasting it in Word document. So here I'm pasting the copied value. Yes, okay. Tip number 5, to set the start transaction. So every time I log into SAP, it directly opens the my start transaction. Okay, how to set? Go to menu bar, click on extras, select set start transaction, enter your transaction. For example, I'm entering MM01. Okay, click on right mark. Yeah, now log off and login. See, now I'm just logging into SAP. It directly opens the MM01 T code. To remove the start transaction, just click on the extras, click on set transaction, just to remove the transaction, click on right mark. Tip number 6, we can make the selected T code shortcut on my desktop. Here, for example, I'm taking this T code. Okay, just right click on this T code, click on the create shortcut on desktop, click on allow. Okay, now just log off this. See here, shortcut came on my desktop. Just double click on this. We can log in, click on allow. Yeah, enter the password, click on login. It directly opens the particular transaction code. See, it's directly opened. So we can also delete the shortcut just select it, this shortcut, click on delete button, it will delete. Tip number 7, how to set the default printer. To set the default printer, click on the system, go to user profile, click on own data, click on defaults. Here we can set the your own default printer. Tip number 8, how to remove the waste data from particular field. For example here, so this is not required. To remove this data, just select this value, click on the delete button from your keyboard. It removes the data. Next time it won't show the that deleted data. Okay. Tip number 9, insert and overwrite mode. So it is in overwrite mode. So what is overwrite mode? So here, for example, I want to change this 8 to 9. So system removes the text. So when I enter the 9, see, it removed the dot. So I don't want this. Just shift it to insert mode. Now enter the dot. It won't remove the any text. So to shift overwrite and insert mode, we can use the insert key from your keyboard. See, I just pressing the insert key, it is changing. So like this, by pressing the insert key, we can shift to overwrite mode to insert mode and insert mode to overwrite mode. Tip number 10, how to set the error, warning or success dialog box. So just go to your customization local layout, click on this, click on options, go to interaction design, click on notifications, select these checkboxes, show error message in a dialog box, select these checkboxes also. Okay, if required you can select the BPUT message. Okay, we can select it, click on apply, click on OK. Now run the one T code, SU01, click on this. See, it is giving the beep sound and also it is showing the dialog box for error message.